Sestri, I'm Malaika. For the next half an hour, we're going to be talking tech, from gadgets to gizmos to stuff happening on the web, what to buy, how to buy, whether you should buy or not, and best buys. That's all happening on the show. But first, let's take a sneak peek at what's in store for us. On the show, find out how to go online without Wi-Fi or Ethernet. We go web surfing and find an amateur filmmaker's guide to video editing. Fuel up your gaming experience with the Gran Turismo 5 Prologue. And yes, exciting times on the show ahead, but now our hot gadget on Tech Tree is a phone, something beginning in M, it is a smartphone, and there's the alphabet Q involved. We're saying hello, Moto, to the Moto Q. Let's get to know the phone a little bit more. The latest offering from Motorola is an attempt to hook in the high flyer. The Moto Q98 smartphone is Motorola's second entrant in their Q phone range, and it has gone through some evolutionary changes. Check your mail, create your presentation, forget about your laptop while you prepare for that meeting. The styling may not have that wow factor, but the phone does push the performance envelope quite a bit. Next time you're stuck in a boring meeting, you know what you have to do. Get some happy with your mobile phone. Now it's time to bring in the boys. Yes, Tech Guru Deepa versus Tech Enthusiast Sagar are going to fight it out, and you're going to love this. They're going to break the phone down for us in terms of style and design. The Moto Q98 dons a business-like black look. It weighs more than its earlier version, the Moto Q9, but retains a slim look. Besides the full-size QWERTY keyboard, the phone has a 2.4-inch crisp display. It has a shiny black front and a rubber-finished back. The ridges on the function keys, the swappable slot on the side, also aim to up the style quotient.
When it comes to the style front, it doesn't do great on style. It's not a flaunt value phone necessarily. It's a business phone at the end of the day, and that job it does really very well. Not necessarily a very stylish phone, but pretty functional.
It's thin, though. It's much thinner than other phones. It's thin and nice when you look at it this way, but as soon as you hold it like this, this looks like a brick. In terms of styling, it's not very new age. It doesn't have too much of gloss, you know. It looks very rubbery, very understated. This is something I wouldn't want to be caught with, yeah.
Each key is rounded horizontally, making it finger-friendly and adding to the edgy look of the phone. They are well-sized and nicely packed together, but the matte finish reduces the sheen.
On the style front, I'd give it 2.5. Why? Well, fingerprint magnet, keypad is rubber, that's a bit tacky, to be honest. It's not a phone that you take it to a party and necessarily show off to people.
Motorola does try to bring in that slight edge when it comes to style, but I guess it didn't work for Deepak because he gave it a 2.5. I did try out the phone myself. I wanted to see how slim it was, and you know what? It's a smart phone with a lot of attitude. It refused to fit in my pocket. It just me. Let's hope it does better in terms of performance. The Q98 works on Windows Mobile 6 OS and has been customized to include select useful features. It offers 8 messaging inboxes for corporate and personal email. It is also HSGPA enabled, but sadly, we cannot use it in India yet. It works on a 96 MB RAM, which is more than what most other phones offer. You can use up to 2 GB of extendable memory micro SD cards. Special productivity features include an Opera browser and not an IE browser. Makes your internet experience much faster.
Performance, it's a workhorse, as I said earlier. It does the job it's intended to. You're looking at reaching out emails, typing out fast emails. This one does the job for you. Syncing up your calendar, your entries in the notepad or your laptop does the job for you in a jiffy. Browsing is a breeze. what it does when it comes to moving from one app to the other, supposedly you open your Windows Media Player, you open your mail, you open your calendar. If you're migrating from one app to the other, it's a bit sluggish on its performance. But at the end of the day, you'd be possibly using one function at a time, not necessarily using this exactly the way you use your laptop.
What I really like about this phone is that it comes with this smart, nifty-looking device. This is a portable charger. Now, don't get me wrong, all our chargers are portable, but this is something that you charge and you keep it in your pocket and you don't need a socket. You can just plug this in, it just comes with a cable, plug it into your phone and it starts charging. This is something which is really cool. I really like this part about this phone. And it comes free, so more than merry.
No, it's not the pebble. This portable charger instant juice for the phone. You can even use it to charge other devices like Bluetooth headsets with mini USB ports. The phone supports a variety of audio and video formats. The 2.0 megapixel camera comes with digital zoom and an LED photo indicator.
When it comes to its camera, it's a decent camera. So cameras pretty okay for you. I mean, for a business class phone, you don't necessarily looking at, you know, print worthy photographs.
The keyboard, where it loses points on styling, it really gains it on in terms of tactile feedback. As in, you will never ever get a key wrong on this phone. It's really nice. As soon as you press the letter, pop, it comes in front of the screen. It's really nice. Very good tactile feedback.
That seems to be the spotlight feature of this phone. So, if you like to indulge in thumbathons, this could be your phone. Overall, it has good features that make it an able performer.
On performance front, I'd give it 3.5 because it does the job it's supposed to do. It's not brilliant, but it's okay.
Things are looking up for the Moto Q 3.5 and performance, not bad. I really like the add-on on the portable charger. You know, I've been stuck in a situation so many times where you're in the middle of this important conversation and suddenly the phone dies on you. You just want it back in the phone. Now, when you're on the last leg of your battery, simply recharge. Before we go into the final verdict for the phone, let's see how it fares in terms of its competition, the E61i.
The Moto Q is priced a little above 17,000 rupees, while the Nokia E61i retails around 15,500 rupees. The Moto Q does not enable a BlackBerry connection, but one really cool feature is the portable charger, which can hold up to a day's charge.
Well, again, which one would I buy would depend on my need, and my need is functionality, so I would go for this.
There is only one problem with the Motorola. It doesn't have Wi-Fi and it doesn't support BlackBerry. Now, that's a big downer for Motorola, whereas Nokia scores on this front.
Even though Nokia E61i supports Wi-Fi, but as I said earlier, Wi-Fi is not my biggest need on this phone.
Now, in terms of size, the Nokia is bulkier but looks much nicer. But in terms of performance, this phone is an out-and-out winner.
Functionality, comfort, smart fit, all of it put together, I'd definitely go for this.
And TechTree's final verdict on the Moto Q9H is 3.5 stars.
And the final verdict is in, yes, the 3.5 is pretty good, thank you boys. Now, depending on what your requirement is, it is the phone that high-end style quotient, then you will give it an 8. But if you're looking for something that gets its basic price, comes with a decent price tag, and has all the features of a smartphone, then your Moto Q is your phone. And for me, I think I'm looking for something with style and function, fashion and comfort, so maybe I will give this one a skip too. As for now, I think I need a break.
Coming up after the break, use your phone GPRS to go online with your laptop.